What's happening, my friends? JokerXP here, and today I'm going to show you how to unlock the chest in Golgoroth's cellar. Now, you'll make it into this map just by progressing through the King's Fall raid. So for those of you that have already played through these checkpoints, then you know very well what area I'm talking about. Visibility in this area is rough. It's pretty easy to get confused and actually lost rather quick. But this map is not a maze, it's actually pretty straightforward. So for the sake of this video, I'll be using this map courtesy of Reddit user The New Monarch. This shows you the four locations of four plates that you need to stand on, and then the location of the entrance, exit, and the chest. So assign a guardian to one of each of these plates. Don't stand on them just yet, wait a little bit to give time for everyone to get to their plates and actually find them. The third plate is probably the hardest one to get into. So for the sake of this video, I'm going to show you how to get to this third plate. So if you follow this map, you'll arrive at the area where plate 3 will be located. First thing you'll do is jump on this pillar that's right in front of you towards the left side of this left wall. Then there's going to be a second pillar that will be above you. You'll have to jump up. You'll see it hanging out of the upper left side of this left wall. Once you're on top of that second pillar, then the opening to the room will actually be slightly to your right. Now be careful not to overjump it. It's not that much higher above you. Once you've made it into the opening, you are in the room. So just drop down, try to not jump on top of the plate accidentally, and then wait for everyone else to be in position. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the order in which you stand on these plates does matter. The order that worked for my fire team were plates 3, 4, 2, 1, although we've also heard reports that plates 3, 2, 1, 4 work as well. So here's two quick tips to help you out if you're having a hard time actually getting this down. First up, if your problem is you're getting lost too easily, then try having a fire team member stand at the main entrance of this whole maze. Use that fire team member as like a guiding point, kind of like on a map. That'll be like your north point of reference. If that still doesn't help you out, then have a second fire team member head to the exit path to do the same thing so you can have two points of reference, both north and south. Keep in mind though that if your whole fire team heads to the exit door that leads into the next room where you're going to fight Golgoroth, the plates will then be disabled and you won't be able to get this chest. And the next tip is if you step on the right plate, you'll hear a confirmation noise, somewhat of a click type of sound. Although the audio is very loud in this whole room, you'll still be able to distinguish the slight clicky noise. Whereas if you step on the wrong plate, you'll hear this churning type of sound, this loud kind of rumbling churning type of noise. Now this could be slightly confusing depending on your audio setup and depending on your TV or your sound system, but give it a few goes, try it out, and eventually you'll definitely get it down. If you do the sequence correctly, you will definitely hear an undeniable sound of a door opening. It'll be very distinct apart from the other audio cues that you've been hearing so far, and that'll confirm to you that you did it correctly. So now it's time to head to the room and loot this chest. And there it is, my friends. That is how you find the second chest in the King's Fall raid. Let me know your comments or feedback down below on the sequences and different tricks or things that worked for you guys and your fire team. Like the video if you liked it, and thank you for hanging out and watching. I'll see you next time.